Lightfoot, who has insisted upon this match to try and avenge what happened just a couple of weeks ago. Bill Alfonso, the referee, and the Saint wasting no time. And Lightfoot exploding back on the Saint.
I remember very well the match just a couple weeks ago where it seemed like Chief Joe Lightfoot had the match well under control, and something happened that was very controversial during that match. And ever since then, Chief Joe Lightfoot had been screaming and petitioning for a rematch, and now today he has it. Looks like he's going to that mask, trying to pull that mask off of the Saint. I might say that it's very hard to get a mask off. They are tied with a very strong nylon cord under the chin, around the back of the head, and you really have to do something to get those masks off. They are on there to stay.
By the way, immediately following this match, we're going to have a rather disturbing bedside interview with Blackjack Mulligan, who's has been hospitalized. Lightfoot trying for a pinfall, now a snapmare on the Saint. Drives the knee into the side of the head of the Saint.
Well, right now I kind of think it's kind of early in the match for a pinfall with two competitors like this. They are both such well-conditioned athletes. Superb conditioning. It takes a long time for a man to get worn down. Nothing has happened yet to really expel all the energy. Right now you notice Chief Joe Lightfoot has that side headlock laying his weight across the upper chest. Now, the Saint is trying to get a little added leverage by holding the tights, the trunks of Chief Joe Lightfoot, trying for a pin, but right into the ropes, and looks like the Saint is not going to break clean. Chief Joe Lightfoot in a bad position there against the ropes. The referee trying to get the Saint away.
The Saint pretty handy with those dukes, I'll tell you. Hard right hand that puts Chief Joe Lightfoot to his knees. Back to his feet. Snapmare takes him to the canvas again. And the Saint utilizing the flat of the foot.
Any maneuver such as this is designed to wear your opponent down, wear him out, make him use up his energy, soften him up for a possible pinning combination later. Looks like the Chief Joe Lightfoot has kind of got his hand up. He's going out to the Saint.
Good move by Lightfoot, rolling reverse, and as the Saint in near fall, a two count on him, and the Saint drives the knee to the midsection. That neck breaker. Lightfoot's got some problems now.
Well, that neck breaker was very devastating hold. The neck breaker is a finishing hold, and fortunately, Chief Joe Lightfoot was able to come out. Many times that neck breaker is a pinning combination. That takes a lot out of you.
Lightfoot has him tied up in the ropes now, drove into his midsection, and Lightfoot chops into the chest now of the Saint. And again, it's Lightfoot wasting no time, and again, the referee saying no, but wait a minute. Look at the Saint putting on another glove, and brother, I don't know what's in that glove, but he definitely put on the glove, another glove, and that dropped Chief Joe Lightfoot for the count. As I said just a few moments ago, Blackjack Mulligan. One fall.
This should prove to be a very interesting match. Larry Hamilton, being an exponent of the fine arts of wrestling, a former collegiate AAU champion. He's just held numerous titles throughout the country. And then, of course, Jim Neidhart, on the other hand, being big, strong, and powerful, former professional football player. You see him very easily lifting Larry Hamilton up. Larry Hamilton is going to have to stay to the basics of wrestling to be able to combat a man like Jim Neidhart.
Neidhart circling his man, as is Hamilton. Hamilton, of course, the faster of the two. And again, Neidhart brings him up. Full body slam on Hamilton. Hamilton out of the University of Tampa. By the way, the Spartan Spectacular takes place next Tuesday at the University of Tampa Spartan Sports Center on North Boulevard. Hamilton being blocked in his attempt. Good move by Hamilton. Excellent counter. lead to great advantage.
Well, that's exactly what I was referring to earlier. As long as he stays to the basics of wrestling, I've always been a strong believer in that a very well-skilled wrestler can always defeat a larger and stronger man by being able to use that man's own weight against him. Right now, you can see Larry Hamilton hanging onto that arm bar and able to roll him over using the leverage and weight of Jim Neidhart against himself. Here's Larry Hamilton still on the arm bar, and Jim Neidhart in some trouble right now.
Mr. Hamilton acquitting himself extremely well against Neidhart, giving away about 40 to 50 pounds here. And again, Neidhart using the strength and... jammed in that time, and rather slowly, and he uses a forearm into the chest now of Larry Hamilton. Snapmare that has Hamilton back to the canvas once again.
Jim Neidhart just twisting that neck with his reverse chin lock, just putting the pressure on those vertebrae and the back of that neck. You see, Neidhart just putting a pressure on Larry Hamilton in some trouble right now. There's a lot of power in the arms of Jim Neidhart.
Neidhart now with a snapmare on Hamilton, takes him back to the canvas. Came out with a forearm that time. Hamilton back. This time it was Hamilton ducking away from him, catching him in a back drop. Hamilton moves in, explodes with a right and a left. I'll tell you one thing, this Neidhart can take it and then he can dish it out. No question about that.
Well, that's what makes a tough competitor, man, that can't take it. Many competitors cannot take the punishment. Jim Neidhart can take it as well. Gordon.
Hamilton ducks to one side. Hamilton catches him with a beautiful flying drop kick. Hamilton moving him very aggressively now, goes up for a head scissors. Has Neidhart down. Neidhart back to his feet. Hamilton closing. Went for another head scissors, and Neidhart just stopped him right in flight. Brother. Momentum and that crushing weight down on the chest of Larry Hamilton. Their victor in this match is Jim Neidhart.
You found a car dealer.
Good. Good luck. Was no pitch in that? No, that's simple mind. And what's this?
Move. Jerry, when invited like this. But I am the Florida heavyweight champion, and I'm very proud. It's an honor to put this belt around my waist because I'm representing all the people of Florida. Now, I'm not trying to get personal, and I know that you're very tough and you're strong and you've got a lot of guts. And without a doubt, you would have won a gold medal in the Greco-Roman in the 1980 Olympics. But when it comes down to it, you got one head, you got two arms, and you got two legs, just like me.
Well, listen here, chicken. If you're not too chicken, why don't you get in the ring right now, and I'll show you just what all these chickens that you represent, just how much of a chicken you are, too. If you're not too chicken, get in the ring right now. Come on, get in the ring.
Yes, I...
Ho-ho, ho-ho. It looks like he's accepting that challenge.
He sure has. He sure has, brother. We've got one going here. Scott McGee taking definite umbrage to the comments by Jesse Barr. And Barr putting that Greco-Roman wrestling to work, but good ride. And McGee trying to escape. Sit out. He does escape. He's back on his feet. And Barr is a study of frustration now.
Making a comment that everybody here in Florida's chickens, I guess he's seeing right now that he's just blowing a lot of smoke and not a bit of word. No words of that are true. He's hollering chicken at Scott McGee. I think he's going to see something else.
Good reversal by Scott McGee. Scott McGee moves in. Another full body slam on. Caught him with a forearm that rocked him. Caught him again in the midsection. I have rarely far as beginning to find out what kind of a Florida chicken he's facing right here. Brother.
Well, obviously, from what I've seen of Jesse Barr and Dory Funk Jr., they like to fight in pairs. When it's just one-on-one against a top competitor such as Scott McGee or Mike Graham, they don't fare quite so well. But you do have to have eyes in the back of your head when these two men are around. You never know what to expect. It's like Dory Funk Jr. stepping up the step there, now coming back down. Let's just hope that Dory Funk Jr. will stay where he belongs.
Barr with a forearm. McGee retaliates with another forearm, another one under the chin that rocks Barr. Barr is staggered, but Barr fires back. Jesse Barr and Scott McGee. Uses that elbow rather effectively, turns into his man a single leg pickup. The name of the game is wrestling, and that's exactly what's happening here. Both of these men just outstanding wrestlers. Head scissors now by Jesse Barr.
Now it's going to go to Scott McGee, the Florida heavyweight champion, to come out of this hole and for a possible reversal. Let's see what strategy he uses here. Scott McGee has such a vast array of wrestling holds and counter moves that I feel confident he will come up with something. He's pulling the legs apart, trying to come out this way. It's like Jesse Barr is holding onto the hair.
Good move by McGee as he went into those femoris muscles. Another bolo-like forearm of Scott McGee. Misses, and McGee caught with a full body slam by Jesse Barr. Barr again rocks him with a forearm. Irish whip into the far corner. Barr charges in. McGee caught him coming in. Scott McGee, beautiful drop kick, and Barr caught in the mouth, and brother retained his feet, but now. Funk Jr. tripped him up and drove him right straight into the and the referee chastising Funk for, wait a minute, he's got a double cobra on him. He's got a double cobra that's coming across both carotid arteries.
That double cobra hole is a devastating type of sleeper hold. It's one of the worst type of sleeper holds around, Gordon. I have seen that applied before. It cuts off the blood flow to the brain from both sides.
Scott McGee, I'm sure, is virtually unconscious, if not totally unconscious. And Barr still looking like he's... Funk saying something to him, and Barr still looks like he wants to go after Scott McGee. Barr is, wait a minute.
What are they up to now?
Well, he said he had chicken feed, and that's, what is this?
What is going on here?
Like he's spreading tar all over it. Oh, good grief.
In 25 years around professional wrestling, I have never seen anything like this. What?
Oh, this is absolutely...
Those are chicken feathers.
They're tar and feathering him is what they're doing. This is absolutely disgusting.
This is the most reprehensible...
Well, I'll tell you, this bar is on a borderline as far as I'm concerned. He is on a borderline. And we're going to have to get some assistance to...
Now, there's that Florida chicken for you.
Well, that is absolutely disgusting.
I have never seen anything as low-life and disgusting as this, Gordon. This is it.
Well, we'll just have to get some help for Scott McGee, and we'll be back. Championship wrestling will be held this coming Monday night in West Palm Beach at the West Palm Beach Auditorium. Next Friday night, championship wrestling will be held in Freeport at the Freeport YMCA. Saturday night in Nassau at Nassau Stadium. And next Friday night, championship wrestling will be held in Okeechobee, Florida at the Crystal Lake Resort. That's the Crystal Lake Resort in Okeechobee. Some of the stars will be there include Billy Jack, Larry Hamilton, Dick Slater, the St. Angelo Mosca Jr., Mike Allen, and a host of others. That'll be in Okeechobee at the Crystal Lake Resort. Now then, this coming Monday night, championship wrestling will be held at the West Palm Beach Auditorium, and Barbara Clary had these comments.
La Lucha
Championship Wrestling will feature Billy Jack against Harley Race in the main event in a no disqualification match. Mike Graham and Pistol Pez Whatley take on Dory Funk Jr. and Jesse Barr. In a Prince of Darkness death match, Kevin Sullivan goes up against the one-man gang. The Guerrero brothers wrestle the Hollywood Blondes. Dick Slater takes on Chief Joe Lightfoot. The Rock and Roll Express goes up against the Saint and Jim Neidhart. It'll be Crusher Khrushchev against Larry Hamilton. I have Mike Graham and Pistol Pez.
Jack, yeah, you're a great athlete, aren't you? Did God give you those arms?
I had to work for them, brother.
You had to work for them.
18 years I worked for
them. Yeah, well, let me ask you something else. Who's your heroes? They certainly aren't Wallace Berry, John Wayne, Audie Murphy from Hell or Back. No, it's none of them. You know who your heroes are? Would you like to know who your heroes are? I'll tell you who they are. There's some muscle-bound freaks that are strolling around this world that don't have anything except muscles on their shoulders and arms and no brains. Do you realize you're totally synthetic? You don't impress me. Look at yourself. You don't impress me. Who do you impress? Who do you want to impress, Billy Jack?
Listen, man, I'm not much on talk. You got such a big mouth. Why don't you go in the ring and back it up right now, you punk? You got a big mouth. Why don't you back it up? What's this? This is going to hurt me one bit, man. You got to get your butt in the ring.
We'll be back in just a moment. We'll be right back.
Everyone wants to know why.
Everybody in the wrestling world is talking about what happened here last week with superstar Billy Graham and Kevin Sullivan. Well, let me tell you something. Superstar Billy Graham, you're a weaker man than I thought you were because you fell to the weakness of the flesh. Tell them about it, Kevin.
You know, Barbara, when Humperdinck brought the star to me, I brought him myself. I took it upon myself to bring him to Habuda Dean. When I took him to Habuda Dean, I put myself on the line. But obviously, Graham was lusting for that girl. That had nothing to do with it because that was my property, superstar. He went one step too far, and I could see something in him that had to be eradicated right then, Barbara Clary.
I'd like to take another look at that to see exactly how easy it was for us to take care of Billy Superstar Graham, get him out of the picture for good. Go ahead and roll that videotape. I know you got it back there.
All right, let's take a look at the situation.
Down that towel.
Look at him, man.
Now, this is insane. Wait a minute. Superstar Billy Graham just put a stop to that. Superstar cut from behind.
And now they're attacking Superstar Graham.
Superstar Graham trying to stop him from the further entering the lock. And now it is Kevin Sullivan and... hit the scene. Mike Graham just hit the scene and that cleared the area. And
he made the mistake that many, many people have made by sticking their nose where it doesn't belong. When Sullivan was disciplining his slave, Superstar Billy Graham had the audacity to try to stop him, but now Superstar Billy Graham is out of the picture. Now he's not around Florida anymore. Now he's not here to bother me and Sullivan anymore. We've gotten rid of him for good. I'm confident.
Let me tell you something, Barbara Clary. Habuda Dean has instructed me to be the keeper of the gate, and obviously, Superstar, it has never happened to me before. Superstar's your weakness. For 2.5 years, I have reigned without any problems. Superstar caused problems, and it was up to me to get rid of them for good. And what you saw when I smashed the chair on his head and led a vicious attack, I made sure that Superstar would be gone from the face of the earth for good.
Well, that may be so, but I have been sent an audio tape and some photos that are allegedly from Superstar Billy Graham. So why don't we take a look
Wait
at those photos
now.
And listen
no,
to
no,
that
no,
tape
no.
right now.
Humperdinck.
What are you trying to say?
Wait a second.
First of all, Kevin Sullivan, I want you to know that I am alive and I am well. I am not in an Egyptian tomb in Cairo. I am not dwelling with the headhunters on the Amazon River. I am not in the jungles of Borneo and Sumatra with the prehistoric pygmies. Nor am I with the holy men in Calcutta and Tibet. Just as Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, went into the deserts of Judea to fast for 40 days and 40 nights to gain strength to fight the devil, I, being a mere mortal, have also gone into the desert, shackled to this river bottom, to cleanse my soul and spirit and gain the power that I will need to defeat you and Abudadine, to rid myself of every evil thing that you represent, all the filth, the dirt, the slime, the mire, and the disgusting, putrid, sick, inhumane acts that make you what you are, Kevin Sullivan. In the moment that I know that I have been released from the powers of darkness and all the evil spirits have left me, I will break these chains that bind me, tear loose these bonds that hold me. I will rise up from this river bottom grave and be free, free at last. And I will march, crawl, swim if I have to, until I find you. And I will find you no matter how long it takes, for there's no place that you can hide. There's nowhere for you to run. Nothing and no one can save you now. I am coming back. And I...
This is somebody's idea of a bad joke.
It's no joke. No joke, Kaepernick. It's no joke because I know he's at the doorway. I know where he's at. Let me tell you this, Humperdick. You told me he was gone. I don't care if he has to swim, crawl, or fly. I know where he is. He'll be back. He has been... Purge for war, bro.
There's nothing to worry about, Kevin. I've got connections, international connections,
have
Daddy. All over the world. Don't worry about a thing. Don't worry about a thing.
Let's now go to the ring for our next match.
Well, there you have it. Crusher Khrushchev hurtled into the ring against his opponent and wiped him out in a matter of seconds. And there's Khrushchev leaving the ring. All I can say about what we saw a moment ago with superstar Billy Graham, that wrestling fans and wrestlers alike are saying that that was the moment that superstar Billy Graham became a man, no question about it. We'll be right back.